whatever that smells.
Some varnished poo.
Oh, look at that, feels lovely.
And plenty of howling.
Brother!
You betcha!
Alaska.
Our destination for this year's summer expedition.
Most northerly of the 50 states in the USA, it's also the biggest.
It's not just the state that's big. Within it, there are 15 national parks, Mount McKinley, which is North America's tallest mountain, and check this out, bears that weigh up to 360 kilograms. That's five times my weight.
Over the next few weeks, we'll be heading into one of America's last great wildernesses. Hello.
Hello. We'll be delving into Alaska past and present.
And meeting the people and animals who live here.
There are very few roads in Alaska, so we'll be traveling on trains.
Plenty of planes.
And some boats as well.
But first, we're trying something a bit different.
Is this? Woo! A fantastic way to travel. Woo!
That was so much fun.
You were drooling so much up there. It was
I just screamed all the way down. I'm sorry if I deafened you both.
That's all right. Well, if that's not good enough, there's lots of great things to do in Alaska, so I reckon we split up and go see what makes this place special. What do you reckon?
Sounds great.
I've heard there's some decent native culture. I'm going to check that out.
Gold plays a big part in Alaska's history, so I'm going to check that out if that's cool.
Gold? Make sure you bring me a present.
Fair enough.
Well, if I'm going to bring you guys a present, you're going to have to bring me one present as well.
Perfectly fair. Perfectly right.
OK, let's go.
Whoa, one minute. There's one more thing you need to know about Alaska.
What's that?
Well, it's illegal to push a live moose out of a moving plane, so... Can't do it.
Alaska has a pretty interesting history. For thousands of years, it has been home to 11 major native groups. For centuries, they lived in relative harmony with each other. But all that changed in the 18th century when the Russians arrived in Alaska and claimed it as their own. This wasn't uncommon at the time, and other countries around the world, including Britain, were building up their empires as well.
Alaska's size made it difficult for Russia to control. So when the United States offered to buy it off them in 1867 for just over $7 million, they jumped at the chance.
Within a few decades, there were several huge discoveries of gold in Alaska, with oil and other valuable minerals found a little later on. The new owners had struck it rich. Alaska's population exploded as thousands of people headed north to seek their fortune.
But I'm going back much further than the gold rush. For thousands of years, Alaska's native people have been playing games that really test their strength, agility and balance. They started doing it to keep fit, but then they began competing with each other. 47 years ago, some of these games were incorporated into a modern competition called the World Eskimo Indian Olympics. Every year, people come from across the world to take part, and I've been given the chance to train with some of Alaska's top competitors. Oh my gosh, this is just one of the games that you compete in, right?
Yes.
But you make it look easy. Have I got to get my leg up there as well? What's so funny?
When you bring your arms up, bring your knee up at the same time. So
use my arms as a bit of a propeller?
Yeah.
But I have to go off 2 feet, land on the same foot I kicked with, and hit it.
Yeah.
Here goes. No?
So just, if you stand in one place and just kind of...
Okay.
Oh, you're still jumping off one foot.
It's
teasing. How long did it take for you guys to perfect this?
2 years of practice.
So I've had 2 minutes. Am I doing all right?
Yes, yeah, you're doing pretty good for 2 minutes.
You hold a world record, don't you?
Yes.
How high can you actually hit it then?
8 feet, 10 inches.
That's more than 1.5 times my height.
Pretty much.
You're going to have to show us.
Okay.
Confident you can do it?
Yeah.
Look how high that is.
Yeah, it's all pretty simple for us.
Pretty simple.
Yeah.
Whoa, that is impressive. Makes me looking for more rubbish, doesn't it?
Yeah. No, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Thanks, Andrew. I think we should move on. Okay then, Flora, what are you going to show me?
I'm going to show you the seal hop.
Seal hop, okay, that sounds fascinating. What do I have to do?
You have to go into a push-up position like this.
Okay.
And your butt can't be up like that. It has to be straight. And then you just hop.
Oh. The seal hop was traditionally used by hunters. They would hop along wearing seal skins over their backs, mimicking the movements of the animals in order to get closer to them. I'm not sure any seals would be fooled by my hopping, though.
Let's say, like, a polar bear, a big, huge polar bear came up behind you.
Okay.
And you noticed it. And what you'd want to do is you just want to jump out and then run.
She looks like a spring when she does it.
I wonder if seals ever impersonate TV presenters. Oh, anyway, from champion athletes to champions of a different kind, near Fairbanks.
As you're probably aware, during the summertime in the UK, the days stay lighter for longer than they do in the winter. And that's the same here in Alaska. And in some places further north, the sun doesn't set for nearly 3 months. Imagine that. No night. Weird.
I've been invited to meet the Burley family and see the effect of all that daylight.
They've got a plane in their back garden, and because Alaska's so big, there's not many roads, people have to use planes to get about. It's pretty good, isn't it?
Hello. Hello, Sarah.
Hi, how are you?
Good, I'm Joel.
Hi, Joel. I'm Sarah Burley.
Lovely to meet you. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you for coming, and welcome to Alaska.
Let's get in there.
Yeah!
Plants need light to grow, so when there's lots of light, you guessed it, there's a lot of growing, and Alaska is famous for its super-sized vegetables. Time for a look around, methinks.
It's like we're in Jack and the Beanstalk, and I feel like the giant's gonna go, fee-fi-fo-fum, where's my massive cucumber? You forget what I'm saying. Whoa! Look at this one right here! It's a massive tomato. Oh, that's gonna be huge when it's red. Well, this is a really fun hobby, but it's also competition time, as these vegetables are gonna go in the Tanana Valley State Fair later on. We could be amongst winners. Nervous, guys? Woo! Right, they were pretty impressive big vegetables. What is your secret?
The daylight and the running our livestock through this garden.
So, like, your animals are running all around it?
Yes, they use it as a pasture.
Like, so they go to the toilet on it?
Yes.
That's lovely, and that's what makes them grow big and strong?
Well, it's a natural fertilizer.
Because you entered into competitions, have you guys ever won anything, or?
We sure have.
And what vegetables did you enter?
Cucumber, tomato, and broccoli.
And will you be entering anything later on in today's competition?
Yes, my cabbage.
Right, look at all these.
Sarah's son Anthony showed me the cabbage he'd be growing to enter into the competition. But would it be big enough? There was only one way to find out.
Wow, it's really hard. Where are we going to put it?
In the back of the truck.
Right, which is just here. Didn't even see it there. Big head, big thing. Now we're trying not to lose any of the leaves because that is weight.
The Tanana Valley State Fair is one of Alaska's biggest events. Time to see if Anthony's cabbage would impress the judges. I could smell excitement in the air. Or maybe it was just cabbage.
This is a very exciting moment. It's the weight that matters, not the size, the weight. At 11.78 pounds.
That's nearly 5.5 kilograms.
So far, you're in first place in the kids' division.
Mate, look at that. He keeps it contained.
Good job.
Right, it's not all about big veg, it's also about what fun you can have with it. Let's check some out, shall we? But right there, I think there's an aubergine stripped and it's been turned into penguins. This, I believe, is a melon turned into a bus, mushrooms as wheels, radishes as people. That would encourage me to eat my 5 a day. It's a monster. It used to be a courgette. Who would have thought? I wouldn't have. So if you don't like eating your vegetables, why don't you try making something exciting out of it? Just don't let your mum see, you might get in trouble.
Gold is one of the most precious substances in the world. For thousands of years, it's been used as a form of money, as well as in decorations, jewellery, and even food.
I've come to Fort Knox Gold Mine near Fairbanks in central Alaska. It's the biggest gold mine of its type in the entire state, and it produces millions of pounds worth of gold each year.
Lorna, who works here, offered to show me around.
Lorna, this place is huge, but I'm not being rude. I can't really see much gold there. All I'm seeing is this rock. What's going on?
The gold is actually trapped inside the rock, and we actually have to extract the rock to be able to get to the gold.
Okay, so to get a small amount of gold, you need to collect a lot of rock?
Absolutely.
Okay, so how do you get at the rock?
Well, if you turn around, we're about to find out.
It's really crazy how long it takes from seeing it for the sound to actually reach up here. There it goes again.
Each blast contains millions of kilograms of rock, enough to fill around 30 Olympic swimming pools. And it all comes here to be processed.
That's why I'm wearing these earplugs. Lorna's just been telling me that when the rock is blown up, it's put into some giant crushers. And then from there, it's brought into this mill, into these huge drums, kind of a bit like your washing machine. And the rock is mixed in with these giant steel balls, and that crushes it into the consistency of sand. That is amazing, I think. And then the gold is extracted from there. What goes on in here is top secret. The gold is melted down and formed into blocks called ingots. And I've been given very special permission to take a look. It's also quite dangerous in here, and that's why I'm dressed like this. I actually can't believe I'm this close to one of the most valuable metals in the world. And look at that, it just looks like treacle. Look at that. Even just standing this close to it, it's really burning my skin. I'm gonna have to pull this a bit closer.
It might look like treacle, but at this point, the gold was about 1,000 degrees Celsius.
It's like custard, really. When custard cools down, you know, you get that gooey bit on the top. That's what happens to gold when it cools down.
You're ready to pour another bar.
Okay, here we go. Come on, bring it on.
I couldn't believe it. To produce one of these bars requires about 175 truckloads of rock.
Oh, yes. It's pretty cool because basically you turn it over and you've got all this black stuff, and then you crack into it and out emerges this lovely gold bar. It's kind of like finding a golden ticket in the Wonka bar. That is awesome.
Although it had turned solid, the ingot was still really hot. It was plunged into cold water to cool it down.
How much do you think that's worth?
I think it's worth about $35,000.
That's about £15,000. So, my new best friend, buddy old pal, do you mind if I could just take that and borrow it and show the others?
I don't think you're going to get out of here with that. Your pockets aren't heavy enough for that.
Oh, come on, man. I need to show them some gold. What do you think I should do?
You're in Alaska. Go pan for some gold in one of the creeks.
It's not a bad idea.
Before I could go gold panning, I needed a gold pan. Word on the street was that this was the place to come to get kitted out.
This is the variety of pans that we have. Uh-huh. And you can see here there are a variety of sizes.
But how do I know which is going to be the right one for me?
Well, take a look at this. That's a little bit large for you, don't you think?
It just doesn't feel right, to be honest.
When it's full of rocks and water, Andy, you might get tired. If you take a smaller pan, right here.
That's more like
right.
It.
Yeah. Now, that pan full of gravel will be comfortable and you can pan all day with it.
Okay, what else am I gonna need?
You might want to have one of these screens.
Perfect.
Screen the larger rock, discard it, and then pan the fine.
That's kind of like a sieve, isn't it, that you'd have in the kitchen?
Exactly.
Anything else?
You get started with that, and then you'll do fine.
Oh, fantastic. Let's go get some gold.
When you go to the toilet and you do your business, you often think that's the end of it. But not in Alaska, and especially not if you're a moose.
Roger here makes money out of waste. Moose waste, to be exact. And it seems people can't get enough of his moose-dropping earrings. Step one, varnish.
It looks like a chocolate cereal, which has been, like, you know, enlarged. Oh, look at that, feels lovely.
You're turning nuggets into gold now, Joel.
Nuggets into gold.
Nuggets into gold. When you get done mixing those, Joel, you're going to have to put them on this dry rack. Just throw them out on the, there you go. Okay, now these are actually going to have to sit here and dry for about 24 hours.
With the varnish dry, the nuggets, as Roger calls them, are safe to touch without gloves. Good job, because I'm not wearing any.
Okay, so a blob of glue, like so.
Well, you picked a real good gem to make for someone here.
Helen, honestly, she's going to love these. I really hope she wears them. I'll be quite offended if she doesn't.
You don't want too much glue, it'll look tacky. And we don't want this product looking tacky. You got to put it on that poo.
Yeah. I can't say that word. You know, that's why I have to say droppers. I cannot say that word. It's a weird thing which I've had. I can't think of a better way to impress a girl than moose dropping earrings. That's good. That's not a bad look. It goes with your moustache.
Oh, great.
Joel seemed confident with his present, but I was surely onto a winner with gold. I headed to Nome, the home of one of Alaska's biggest gold rushes, to see if I could find some gold. Just over 100 years ago, Nome didn't exist, but when three Swedish men discovered gold in a local stream, it sparked a massive rush as people from around the world traveled here to make their fortune. Very soon, over 5,000 people were living here, most of them in tents, all competed for space as they scoured the area for gold. But at one point, Nome was considered to be the most populated town in Alaska.
And people are still coming here today to find gold, including me.
Meet Buckwheat, a gold panning legend.
Yo, Buckwheat, how you doing, mate?
Hey, how are you, sir? Nice to see you.
Yeah, mate, well, look, I've got all my equipment. Let's do some gold panning, yeah?
Okay.
But before I start, could you just explain a bit about gold panning to me?
Okay, we're gonna use the pan.
Yeah.
Just to look for small pieces of gold and little itty-bitty nuggets, also called kernels.
Okay. How exactly does the gold get into the river, then?
Well, now, you've been down to Fort Knox,
yeah.
Right? Okay, well, the same process is used, right? Gold is attached to rocks.
Okay.
And as it tumbles down through the streams and the rivers, it separates itself.
Okay.
And that's what we're looking for today.
Okay, that sounds good. Let's go, then.
All right, now, just a second. Before we start looking for the gold,
yeah,
we've got to learn how to howl.
You learn how to howl, ain't
you? Yeah, well, because when you find the gold, you've got to shout it out.
Okay,
and
okay.
The best way to shout it out is to howl! Brother!
Nice, okay.
Yeah.
Here we go. Brother!
You betcha!
You like that stuff?
Let's go for it.
Okay, let's go for it. That sounds good to me.
Scoop up some material.
Yeah.
You're gonna get your hands wet. It's cold. That water's cold.
It's cold, all right.
And you wanna shake it back and forth.
Shake it back and forth.
Just down the road, I was knocking up a treat for Andy and Joel.
I asked for a present, so it's only fair I take something back as well. Now, I've heard there's a special native pudding worth trying, and the boys love their grub, so it sounds like the perfect gift. Hey, Josie.
Hey.
Cool cabin.
Mm-hmm.
You're miles from anywhere.
Yes, we love it. Solitude.
I can see why. All right, well, what are we making here?
We are making a gudeg, which is Eskimo ice cream.
So what does it involve?
Blueberries, egg whites, sugar, olive oil, some lard.
Okay. What's Eskimo about it?
Cooked fish.
Fish?
Yes.
Fish. In ice cream?
Yes.
I don't mean to be rude, but that's gross. That is a lot of lard.
It is, I know.
We could do it in an electric whisk. But then, I guess there's no electricity out here.
No, there isn't.
This isn't the healthiest of puddings, is it?
The fish and the berries will make up for it. Everybody loves it. especially the kids.
But do you let them try it first, or do you tell them what's in it first?
I let them try it first.
Yeah, I think I'll try that tactic with the boys.
Okay, it's time for the fish. Squeeze all the juice out.
Oh, that is horrible. It feels so gooey.
The juice is what makes fish smell.
The guys will never know there's fish in this, will they?
Doesn't it look like ice cream, though?
Thanks, Josie. See ya. I'm not sure what the boys are going to make of this. There's only one way to find out.
Oh, this is a big one. That's a very big one. All right.
Look at the size of that. That can make enough coleslaw for, like, the whole world.
The competition was tight, and despite their early lead, things weren't looking good for the Burleys. This one was over twice the size of Anthony's cabbage and was the eventual winner.
That's a big one. 27 points.
Anthony had to settle for fourth place.
Fourth place is 11.78.
It's perfect, Andy, just perfect.
How do you know it's really gold, mate?
Okay, well, the stuff that you see on top, that is called biotite mica, fool's gold.
Fool's gold, eh? I'm thinking in the past, way back when gold mining probably begun, a lot of people were done by fool's gold and thought they actually hit the real stuff.
Oh, that's right. I mean, even today, people still bring in stuff that they think is gold, and it turns out to be mica. You see how the rocks have fallen down to the bottom?
Yeah.
And that's good, right? Now, see, the gold would be right up here at the top.
Okay. Is that because it's obviously heavier than the other ones?
It's heavier, and it'll stay up here. Material that's not as dense goes to the bottom of the pan.
Well, we don't seem to be getting anything just yet, do we?
No, sir. We aren't.
What? I'm feeling a bit lucky today because just over 100 years ago, the first guys that found gold in Nome found it just behind me. So what do you reckon, Buckley? Do you reckon we're going to find some?
I think we're going to find some. I think we're going to find some.
And what are you going to do when we find one?
I'm going to let out a howl, brother.
Oh, come on, baby. He's got gold
there
fever.
There it is, right here, right
Hold
here,
on,
right here.
Have you got
right
some?
Here, we got it. No. We're right there, right there. That's what we came up here for, brother. Ow!
Buckwheat, you found some gold!
Yeah. Oh, yeah!
How much is it, then?
Well, it's not too much. That might be a dollar's worth.
Oh, it's like 50, 60p, isn't it?
That's right.
Well, somehow I don't think I've got enough to get my flight home. I'm going to have to keep on searching. Oh, what's
it's
wrong?
It's going to take a while.
I might not have found any gold of my own at the creek, but with this, I might just get away with it.
Back at the fair, it wasn't long before I was due to meet up with the others. I was feeling a little bit peckish.
And it seems to me that this is the place to test your palate. There's a lot of foods which I've never seen before, so I'm quite eager to try them all out.
Americans love their food, so I knew there'd be plenty of treats in store for me. Only thing was, nearly all of it was fried.
Chicken, have some more pie. It doesn't matter if it's boiled or fried. Just eat it.
I want an elephant ear. What is it?
It's a sweet dough that we roll up and fry and put your choice of sweet toppings on it. We have strawberries, blueberries, honey, cream cheese frosting, maple.
Just found something that could be quite healthy. It's mushrooms, deep fried, of course.
Good?
Oh.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Dip the artichoke in the sour cream.
Nope, the butter.
Try the deep fried chocolate roll pastry thing and then the biscuits deep fried.
Okay.
This will be the end of Joel as you know it. I didn't even really get started, did I? After eating all that rubbish food, I've never been so happy to see some fruit. Lovely.
After travelling for hundreds of miles, it was time to meet up and share the treasures we'd collected for each other.
That's good.
Yeah, I went gold panning and I got some gold. Yeah.
You found some real gold?
Oh, yeah, I found real Alaskan gold, yeah.
Mate!
Come on, let's have a look.
Oh, hold on.
I'm impressed, Andy, well done.
Check that out.
I got a little present.
That is real Alaskan gold.
Look, something special, just picked it out before for you.
What is that?
That's a price tag.
Okay, basically this is what happened, right? We were panning for gold, but we really didn't get enough to give you a substantial amount.
Cheap, very cheap. May I present to you the best present of all? Some lovely earrings to go with your beautiful hair.
They look like coconuts, isn't
they? They're unusual. They're nice, aren't they? Are these really for me?
Yeah, yeah, they're made of moose droppings.
Moose poo.
If you,
you
will,
want me to put those in my ears?
Mate, you're a charmer, aren't you?
I know.
Ladies love me. Now, this is a special native dessert that I made.
Brilliant. Oh, great.
It's a little bit runnier than
I thought.
Yeah,
is it melted?
Honestly, you're going to love it. Get stuck in.
Give us some more. There you go.
Get a good mouthful, you know, really taste the flavours.
Well, that's good.
So it's got lots of berries in.
Berries are really good.
A bit of sugar, a few egg whites.
Egg whites, I like egg whites.
No, there's something weird about that. No, no more.
And a bit of fish.
What do you mean fish?
I can taste it. I knew it tasted a bit weird.
Big chunks of halibut in there, guys.
Really?
All right, that's not for me.
And there's quite a bit of lard in there as well. In fact, there's a lot of lard in there. Let's go and dance it off, guys. Come on.
Are you serious? Yeah, actually serious?
Still to come in our Alaskan adventures. We head into the wilderness.
Thoughts of bears and stuff are just playing on your mind.
You lot, there is definitely something out there.
It's really, really scary.
I take on Andy in a lumberjack competition.
We can be lumberjacks!
We descend into one of the most dangerous places on Earth.
If you fell in, no one would ever see you again.
I show off my kayaking skills.
Whoa!
Got it.
I have a go at wildlife photography.
Got it. Look, bear catching a fish.
Joel and I decide to have a race against a train.
Train's ahead of me. Faster than I thought.
One more into it!
Come on, Ellen! She's the one in the yellow helmet. Come on, Ellen! There you go! Oh, yes! Very nice!
But before we left Fairbanks, there was just time for a celebration with some traditional dancing.
Eskimo dancer.
Welcome to my house. Come on, I'll show you around. This is my brother Max's room. Yeah. So annoying. This is my room. And this is the den, where I chill out and catch up with Sam and Toby, my two best mates. We do the usual stuff. Group hug and some unusual stuff.
Danny's House, a brand new comedy starring Danny Harmer. Fridays at 4:35, CBBC on BBC One. Hang out at Danny's House.